Hello, Facebook, YouTube. The day of Jejudea, the archangel that rewards people for their spiritual labor if they're laboring in the vineyard. You know what I'm saying? The vineyard of the kingdom of God, you know, showing forth the love of God towards one another and, you know, sharing his truth, you know. Labor. In the vineyard, heaven rewards you. That's the archangel that's supposed to reward you, but not, you know, the pagan false goddess, what's Fig? I think her name is Fig, aka Venus, flytrap, you know. All right, okay, all right, interesting day. Well, today is, if you want to know, is that there's two Purims. There's a Purim of Queen Esther. There's a Purim of Joshua. And that's quite interesting that, you know, there's two Purims are back to back to each other. What is God up to? Yeah, but the only way you will know what God is up to if you more likely seek and find him. Yeah, you won't know what God is up to if you just sitting back and just not seeking him. Yeah. That's what the idea, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, is about. The idea of, you know, that you seek out the things of God. You know what I'm saying? That is considered of him. It's about not, you know, everybody think it's about, you know, seeking forth the kingdom of heaven. And it's about me. No, it's about God's kingdom, not you building your kingdom. I hope you understand that's how it's supposed to work. But God will try the hearts of men and see what they're going to do with his word. And is they going to be about building his kingdom or making their own kingdom? All right. Okay, let me get to the message. Well, the topic of the message I want to talk about is important. It's the reality of a spiritual fix or a natural fix. I hear, you know, people use that slang term of fix concerning, you know, if someone, you know, needs something to pick them up some kind of way, they will turn to this fix that, you know, in a world, concerning the world sources, whether it's a, you know, drinking or smoking or what, fooling around or something that will fix them. They look at, they perceive these things as something that will fix them and they will be all right. They're looking at things that is considered as sin to fix them. You know, well, you know, I hope you understand where I'm coming from. There's nothing wrong with drinking wine, but, you know, we're not supposed to get drunk off of wine. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, you drink other stuff to get drunk off of, and drinking this, you know, subtracts, well, anything of the earth that you indulge in will cause a subtraction inside you, and you think that being subtracted will fix you up. Well, the serpent more likely has got you believing that, because the thing is, you know, a lot of people try to, you know, think that they can fix their life, you know what I'm saying, in other ways, you know what I'm saying. If I just get somebody, that's the most popular. If I just get somebody in my life, that person will fix my life. Or if I can just get something from this earth, it will fix my life. You know, people got this idea, and you know they want to have this idea. Because here's the thing that, you know, God taught me about, you know, people that look at the earth as a treasure. They want the earth as a treasure because it's easy to get hold to. You know what I'm saying? People will want something of the earth to fix them, because they're closer. The earth is right there, right there. You don't have to go here. You have to, I mean, you could just go over here or go over there. Like the drug dealers. They just hang on the corner for anybody or somewhere else, and anybody needs some drugs. Bam, they're right there. You just get there. Bam, get the drugs. Bam, get it. Get the fix. Bam, you're cured. You're cured. And that's the ideal of a lot of people, unfortunately, these days. They think that there's a fix, something in this earth can fix them right up, and they can continue performing their duties as going to school and going to work and going to being in a relationship, having kids, and doing all kind of stuff. They think something in this earth will fix it. But here's the question that you have to, honest question you need to ask concerning this theory. The thing is, first of all, who made you? Who created you? You know what I'm saying? Should be the question. Like, for instance, if I, had a Cadillac and I want my Cadillac fixed, it broke and I want to get it fixed, and I'm having difficulty of going to this mechanic. The mechanic don't know how to fix it. This mechanic don't know how to fix it. I sit back and say, who can I get to really fix this car better, the best way as possible? I think, Cadillac will have some kind of better ideal of helping your car to be fixed, because let me see here. They created it. Yeah, they will have a better shot at finding a way to fix it, to get it resolved. But the thing is, the question is, who made you? Did a person from the earth or of the earth made you, or somebody of the spirit of, from the spirit of heaven, of God, spirit of heaven that is, God made you, a God of heaven. I meant to try to say the God of heaven made you. That's the question. That's the two scenarios that you have to consider concerning your judgment on whether who can fix you or not. You know what I'm saying? That you need to honestly ask and honestly look to receive the right answer. Because here's the thing about, I learned from sinners, sinners, a sinner mindset. They don't like to be honest. You know what I'm saying? I hear honest situation. And when something that you present to them that is unknown to them, that they don't know, they kind of like try to get off the subject of seeking and searching what is the true solution of the situation, because they kind of want to have a rattlesnake, but don't want it to bite them. They kind of want to swim in a shark tank, but don't want the shark to bite them. They kind of want a tarantula to crawl on them, but don't want the tarantula to bite them. That's how they kind of see sin, They kind of see their actions of what they're doing that is, taking, subtracting from their body and making them less than a person. But they want to ignore the idea of what that I have to learn to get rid of this thing right here to start to become a better person. They want to ignore that idea. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, here's the thing. As much as you want to be ignorant to the fact of the very thing that's attracting to you, as much as you don't want to really improve in life to really become a better person, that you have to honestly and mature up to understand this reality. that you need to get an understanding that you need a better substance inside of you, you know, to help you become a better person. You know, you need this substance to, you know, be inside you to, you know, to really give you something. God blew breath, you know what I'm saying, and made man a living soul. And the thing is, you know, people not understanding that, people need to come to understand that God can only, he blew breath, according to Genesis, he blew breath and became a living soul. And the thing is, we got to understand that, you know, man can only become a living soul. We can only be who we are concerning our Creator. You have to come to that understanding. Now, notice I didn't say you have to know that. No, that's carnal mind. The carnal mind is enmity with God. The carnal mind know this and know that and know that, and that's all they know. That's all they need to know. And they know what they're doing. So forget about everything else. They got it all together. You know what I'm saying? And the carnal mind, that's the way it thinks. But when you understand within your heart and start understanding that, you know, I need to seek and ye shall find, and knocking the doors be open concerning the things of our Creator to find a solution to the problem, that's when true change can start and be developed at you doing that. And that's where true change can happen. Truly, that you can really become a better person, that something spiritual can fix you, and you can throw away all the natural fixes and get the right fixes, because only Jesus, like the song said, can fix it. And I hope you can come to find that out in you, in your honest research and finding out your solution, come to find that out. But just sitting back and thinking that these natural things are going to fix you is not going to get you nowhere. It's not. That's what people need to understand. But I hope this message can help you realize that reality, have you get real eyes to realize that you are living a real life. If you think this world gonna fix you, only Jesus can fix you, and nothing more, nothing less. Your person that created you can do that. All right, that's a message. To God be the glory, him forever and ever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen.